All right, it's about 12 hours before Shabbat dinner, but Scott Movie Mantz here to talk about, among other things, American Pickle. We're going to air a conversation, Scott, later this morning with Seth Rogen and myself that I conducted earlier in the week, and we talk about the very Jewish nature of this movie. I don't know, including that or setting that aside, is it a good movie? Good morning.
Good morning, Sam, and good morning, everyone in Los Angeles. Yes, An American Pickle is a very good movie. It is not what I expected at all from Seth Rogen, and I mean that in a really good way. It's more of a dramedy than an all-out comedy. So what it lacks in laughs, it makes up for it with a very big heart. Seth Rogen playing two roles. He's great in both of them. And Sam, I'm glad you touched on these things because this is a film about embracing your heritage and reacquainting yourself with your ethnic origins. And this is from Seth Rogen. Poignant, touching, very moving film. I loved it. What did you think?
You know, it's funny because you use words that I think we normally would not associate with Seth Rogen, particularly how poignant it is, particularly how touching it is. And it's that kind of movie that I'm happy to show my kids and I know my grandmother would have loved. You know what I mean?
I completely agree with you. And I think in this day and age, for a film like this to be out there, it's streaming now on HBO Max, and it's absolutely worth seeing. I think it is a great thing that this movie is out there with all of the themes that it touches on. Very, very positive, very inspiring film. I just loved it.
Bro, that's really good to hear in that Seth conversation a little later this morning. All right, this one I have not seen. I want to see it. I know my wife wants to see it. Everybody's in love not only with Liam Neeson, but with his son. The movie's called Made in Italy.
Made in Italy is on demand now. So Liam Neeson and his real-life son, Michael Richardson, play a father and son in this film, and they basically go to Italy to repair the house that Neeson's character, his late wife, left behind. This movie is a metaphor of sorts for the two of them, because it's sort of based on the grief and the recovery of the loss of Neeson's real-life wife, Natasha Richardson. So knowing that, it gives the movie more depth and more heft. It's a pretty cliche when it comes to father-son bonding, but it's a moving film, touching, intimate, perfect balance of drama, heart, and humor. Worth seeing on demand for sure.
All right, and then finally to The Secret Garden, the title. You tell me how many, this is Secret Garden version 4.0, 5.0, I don't even know.
I'm going to go with 5.0. I actually looked it up on IMDb. There are quite a few versions of this Secret Garden based on the classic book from 1911. This one is for the current generation. It's about a girl who goes to live with her father on a big, huge mansion and the secret garden that's behind it. It's the classic coming-of-age story, very delicate, very exquisitely rendered. And I have to say, the bottom line about this version of Secret Garden is if you loved the movie Little Women, then you will love this version of Secret Garden. It's on demand, also very much worth seeing, and it's for the whole family. Check it out.
You know what's interesting, Scott? If we were having this conversation during non-pandemic times, for the first weekend in August. August traditionally is sort of a dump period. It's interesting to me that essentially there's three here with real merit out this weekend.
Absolutely. You know, when we get into the deeper days of August, like late August, then we get into what we call the dog days of summer, sort of a dumping ground for big studio films. The first couple of weeks, though, you have like the last of the big blockbusters, like a Mission Impossible film or like the Bourne Supremacy or the Bourne Ultimatum back in the day. But this is great that all these movies are now streaming on demand and on HBO Max. My pick for the week definitely is An American Pickle. The best thing I've seen Seth Rogen do, and he does it twice.
Well, there you go. All right. American Pickle, as Scott mentioned, available on HBO Max. Made in Italy is available at drive-in theaters, video on demand, Secret Garden. Available on video on demand. And that conversation that I had with Seth Rogen, an important one, we'll play with for you after 9 this morning. Go back to the two of you.
I'm a little disappointed. As Scott will know, Chekhov says if there's a gun on the wall in the first act, it must be fired. There is a guitar
I saw
against the wall
right.
with Scott Movie Mantz. It must be played. Do we have time?
I don't know if he's got the. Scott, can you play the guitar?
I can play the guitar.
Go ahead.
Let's hear it.
Yeah.
Bang something out.
Play?
Yes.
Play
Heck yes. Oh, we don't have time for tuning. Come on, let's go.
He's a huge Beatle fan. I know that.
Let's roll, baby.
All right. You ready? Okay, wait. All right, okay, here we go. Ready?
Yeah.
Imagine there's no heaven.
Wow.
It's easy if you try. Below us, above us, only sky.
I love it. Thank you.
Oh, yes, Scott!
Yes, who knew?
Scott Movie Man.
I love him so much, and now even more. Because you know what? You got to be ready when someone has.
Yes.
And he was ready.
Wow.
Thank you, Scott. Have a good weekend.